Welcome to the IVM Podcast Network.
If you like poker, and that's P-O-K-E-R, then this is the show for you. Mera Kaam Poker with Azim Banathwala, great comedian, belly dancer, and superb theologian. Also Peter, we don't know anything about him. Mera Kaam Poker. New episodes out on the IVM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcasts from. Alright, please note that the language and ideas presented on the show might not be suitable for everyone. If you're under 18, make sure your mom isn't around. If you're over 80, why is your mom around?
You're listening to Cyrus Says.
Okay, here on Cyrus Says, time to discuss a very important thing, that is physical habits. You know, like digging this and digging that. I, for example, find that if I dig the back of my head where I have dead skin having had an accident as a child there, I feel a lot of peace and tranquility immediately. And I do it all the time. People get irritated because it makes sounds, but I say, let me do it. Because if I don't dig here, I will start digging in my nose or elsewhere. So it's better I dig here or you're going to suffer the consequences. It's called Cyrus Says.
And that's what Cyrus says.
Okay, it's our 200th special. We call it Spebisode. It's neither a webisode nor an episode. It's a Spebisode. It's unbelievable that we have 200 shows. The first 100 were trial and the next 100 were error. So I think now we'll get into the main basis of the show. In the 300, 400 point, I think we'll get to a point where people will accept and understand what we've got to say. But we have in our special some of, I won't use the word fans, but people who write into us regularly. We pulled together our resources and found there were three such people. Two were my parents, so we've eliminated them. But we do have a guy here who goes by the name of Dutt Pandit. Is this the correct name?
Yes, that's absolutely right.
Dutt, thank you for coming here. Firstly, thank you for listening or downloading our show. I don't know if you download, but for some reason you are participating in the show and sending us emails. So thank you very much for that. First, we'll give you 30 seconds to introduce yourself because we don't know anything about you.
Oh, okay.
So quickly, Dutt Pandit, you are famous for many reasons.
Oh, yeah, especially for my name, first of all.
Yeah, what kind of name is that? Yeah, half Sanjay Dutt, half Shiv Pandit. Both actors, both stunting.
I mean, the Pandit, it's for like something specialization, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, my parents knew I would do nothing of that kind. So they thought.
So you're a reverse Pandit.
Yeah, reverse.
You're a Pandit who actually is a Pandit about nothing.
Yeah.
Excellent. I like it. You belong to our show. You may replace me soon. Yeah. You're better looking and younger.
Oh, thank you.
And Dutt part as a first name?
Maybe God, I guess.
I guess, okay, alright. You're not revealing your cards. His real name is Michael Gonzalez. Where did Dutt Pandit come from? I don't know. Alright. So is this really your real name?
Yeah, this is my real name on my passport, yeah.
On your passport, wherever you've been, when you joined the Chota Rajan gang for the first time, this was the name given
to
you.
Yeah, this was.
Okay. So now we have to talk about the show because we're glorifying our show, which is called Cyrus Says, as you know.
Yeah.
But we're going to allow you to do, you're like a member of our trust or the committee that runs the show now. So you can suggest anything and you can make changes that you want, huh? So we're going to start with by asking you a few questions just to check how much you remember of the show. Okay. Which was your favorite, let's call it, episode?
The one with Rahul Subramanian.
Ah.
Oh, that was like the best.
Rahul Subramanian. I remember it like it was yesterday. Naveen, what a fantastic episode that was, I must say. Do you remember any highlights and anything that maybe a conversation or a word or a phrase?
The starting line, like it's of all the episodes, like if you are below 18, make sure your mom is not around. That's the best part. And
but you really shouldn't be listening to
that's
our
really
show
correct.
With your parents. I mean, what kind of life is that, Mr. Pandit?
Huh? Yeah. Huh. And the next thing is the one where Rahul said that he checked on Google, what's your calling?
Huh.
Even I did that after that.
And?
Yeah. And it gave me some weird results. Like, the first one was, it said, I should be a social activist.
Really?
I don't know what kind and no idea.
Social activist can mean many things, huh? Anything is a social activist. A person who just helps somebody cross the road is a social activist. A person who decides to go to a party and misbehave is a social activist. Because you're doing some activity in a social area. So it's very clear.
Then I guess the people who ban non-veg, I'm anti against them because I love non-veg.
And so you take this episode to point out your crusade, which is to bring non-veg back to the masses.
Yeah.
That's your aim.
I mean, it's the way of life, right?
I don't know. I'm a little conflicted because I'm an animal lover and I want to give up non-veg, but I can't.
Yeah, even I'm an animal lover. Yeah. They're so tasty, right?
Yeah, it's like those women who say they love girls but molest them?
Oh.
We are in that category at the moment. Okay? Except ours is even worse crime. Because we're actually eating animals and saying you want to protect them.
Yeah.
So now you tell us in your own, pretend this is like a Miss India contest and your question is, how does Cyrus Says make you a better person? And you've got to answer this to win the contest. Remember, there's no bikini round, so this is very important.
It's really refreshing, like I don't know whether to say this
or please no. Sound sincere, but yeah, even if you don't want to be. Huh?
No, no. I've listened to other podcasts, but they're like, okay, nice. But
name people who are terrible in the podcast. Give me five worst podcasts. We'll promote their bad podcasts also.
That's the video podcast, so that's, I can say.
Thank God, we can't afford that because without makeup, I can't really go on screen anymore. And yeah. We don't have the budget. Yeah, so.
And that's what I was saying. I and Mahim are actually the room. We were roommates back in Detroit.
You and Mahima?
Yeah, Mahim Gautam.
Oh, Mahim Gautam, I thought Mahima Ritu Chaudhary, the actress. Which makes you Subhash Ghai. Which means I should talk to you more.
Yeah.
So Mahim Gautam and you were roommates where?
In Detroit.
What are you saying? So that's true. I thought it was all a joke.
No, that's true.
So you guys are really in Detroit, America?
Yeah.
Which is a city which in America looks down on. Am I right?
Yeah. I've lived in Detroit, so I can live in
It's like the Bhandup of US.
Yeah.
And nobody's proud to be from Detroit, except the criminals.
Yeah.
What the hell are you doing in Detroit?
Doing my master's
in
mechanical engineering.
What are you saying? We have so many engineering colleges in India, you went all the way to Detroit.
Yeah.
You could afford the Indian ones, huh?
Yeah, that's right.
So tell us a little bit about your life in Detroit. Lots of girls?
No.
Huh?
No, that's why I came here again.
All the way to America, land of sunshine, middle of Detroit and nothing.
Nothing,
really?
Yeah. No.
Okay, so let's get back to our show, which is called Cyrus Says, and since you're supposedly a fan, tell us how we can improve the show. Give us two or three points where we can, you know, make it more interesting or more fun.
I guess if you're...
Other than just get rid of me.
No. That's the best part, actually.
Me is the best part?
No, not the gay getting rid of you.
Not gay, me.
Get rid of you.
What the hell are you talking about? This guy's drunk. Where are you from? Detroit.
If you have a video thing, it would be good, I guess.
A video thing?
I mean, video podcast.
Have you seen the standard of our guests? Some of them are really ugly. I got to be honest with you. Sometimes guests are so ugly, I ask them to face the wall and I talk to them. Because the audio is great. You can't tell
the
audio
is the best. Yeah.
But if you see them, you'll be like this Rahul Subramanian. If you actually see him, God. He himself says there are no mirrors in the house. It's like that. Apparently, I've just got this news which has just been handed to me that you've come all the way from Pune. During when we record this, is Ganpati is just finished, which makes it probably a difficult week to travel in. And you come all the way from Pune just to do this 10 minutes or 15 minutes with us.
It's like once in a lifetime, right? For me. So.
Well, I hope not. We're hoping to have you as a regular now.
Since you enjoy the journey,
can you come every day?
Yeah, I would love to do. Just, I need to travel.
So, what are you doing in Pune at the moment?
I returned from US in December.
So you got a job?
No.
What do you do then? You got an engineering degree and you're hanging around in Pune outside Wadia College looking at girls and whistling?
No.
Ferguson?
No, I just take like projects like a freelancer.
You're working in Nandu's as a caterer?
No, you're serving
tables? What are you doing?
Mechanical projects like crash related
things.
Okay,
so you're taking a project at a time. This is the new way of working.
Yeah, I'm trying to
self-employed
make
in a sense.
Yeah, I'm trying to make a mark. I don't know whether...
Paisa hai ya na?
Ab tak to nahi hai.
What are you saying?
Yeah.
What has this Detroit done to you, brother?
This is the first... I got a first project like 2 weeks ago.
Don't worry. It'll all happen. Yeah. In good time, it'll all happen. I'm just saying this. I have no idea what will happen in his life. But he's been nice to us, so we can't be bad to him. All right, bro. Cheers. Great. Nice meeting you. As we leave, I'll ask you five important questions just so that people know who you are, because I hope you continue to write to us regularly.
Yeah.
We have you. We have your name flashing all the time in our webisodes, kebisodes, whatever they're called. It's a podcast. So here's the question. Tell us very quickly. Favorite color?
Red.
Favorite female heroine?
Female heroine? Yami Gautam.
Favorite older heroine?
Older Hema Malini.
Favorite older than that heroine?
No, I've not watched.
Favorite older than even that heroine?
No.
Favorite heroine who's dead last 50 years?
Everyone says Madhubala, so I guess.
Finally got an answer. Fair enough, bro. I'm just kidding around. Okay, so we'll see and hear more from you. And hopefully have you on the show from time to time.
Yeah.
You are now equity holder in Cyrus Says because we've got five or six of you guys who are the ones who've written to us the most and interact the most. So we're definitely going to sort of put you inside the show in some way or the other.
Thank you so much.
And thank you so much. If you can pay 25 lakhs to the receptionist on your way out, that settles the whole issue. And the equity will be sent to you directly.
I'll try.
Thanks, Baba. Cheers.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Okay, once again on Cyrus Says, we have arguably the guy who's, in touch with us the most. What is the right word to use on the internet? In touch is a better word. I don't want to say like calling up or whatever, sending us questions. Mahim Gautam, welcome.
Hey, Cyrus. Hi. Hi, Naveen.
Hello.
And let me just say to everybody out there who's listening, Mahim Gautam himself is in LA, is it? No, Detroit.
No, I'm in Detroit, yeah.
You're in Detroit. But in India, we don't know the difference. So Detroit is in LA, as far as we know. It's somewhere there. Yeah. What's the time difference?
It's 10 and a half hours right now.
You're behind us by 10 and a half hours. And yet America has the cheek to call itself a first world country when it's clearly behind India by 10 and a half hours. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the proof from an American Indian or Indian American. There's a difference, though, in both that. Maim, sorry.
We have Donald Trump.
You have Donald Trump. If I mention who we have, I'll have to come there. So just be careful.
You're Mulayam Singh. So not.
Whoa, where? Not where? What does he do? He's got a petrol pump now in Lucknow, which he's running himself. He's got no work.
He has no work, right.
Okay, Mahim, a quick thing. Is this like a superhero thing that you do where you've taken this name, this nom de plume called Mahim Gautam? But what is the real name? Or are you not allowed to disclose it because of security?
No, we can discuss it. So this name was given to me by my grandfather, and he was a Shiv Bhakt. And Mahim is one of the names of Lord Shiva.
What are you saying?
Yeah.
Look at us morons. Here we thought you have some connection with Mahim, which is a part of Mumbai, iconic part of Mumbai, that too. And now it turns out that he was a Shiv Bhakt, and Mahim is actually one of the avatars. And oh God, this is completely different. And Gautam is, of course, Buddha.
One of the guests on the show also made the joke, like, he's Mahim, what is his friends called? Dadar, Boreali. And I was like, that's too far. Like, that's been done.
You know our standard. We don't want it to rise. Otherwise, you'll have to go somewhere with this show. We want it to stay where it is.
I know the standard. That's why I was calling you. I'm as low as you guys.
No, brother, listen. We are like good Indian politicians. You want to survive, you do nothing. That's how the train keeps running. All right.
We want to keep blaming other people.
No. We are very happy in India. You're very happy in Detroit. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Moving on. What is the real name then? What is there a real name or this is it?
This is the real name.
One second, I need to hold for applause and laughter. Mahim is his real name. Ladies and gentlemen, Mahim is his real name. Okay, excellent, brother. What do they call you in America? They must have changed your name to what? I don't know, Mark?
No, they just asked me twice. That's it.
Asked you twice because they can't get the word. It's not a difficult word, Mahim.
Yeah. But sometimes they're just not used to it, so they ask me twice. That's it.
Yeah, and if they have a draw like in Texas, Mahim will become Mahima, and then you're that fancy female from Bollywood who Subhash Guy once paraded in a movie called
Pardesh.
Pardesh.
Cyrus, I know my Bollywood.
Pardeshi. I can't try to remember the damn song. Yeah. Sorry, we're here to talk about Cyrus Says, since you're one of the few people who actually download or occasionally listen to us. Can you tell us about your best experiences, worst experiences, anything that comes to mind?
Listening to you talk about Mr. Modi.
Which one? Lalit or Narendra?
Both.
All right. And which is your favorite episode? Is there any favorite one that stands out? One episode or one guest speaker, perhaps?
I think Jose and Suresh were like enlightening.
Oh, Jose and Suresh, two philosophers. Lovely, lovely. Just got married. Yeah. Just allowed in Detroit, by the way. Just got married. Jose and Suresh. They're going to have twins, apparently. Yeah, a lot of people like that episode.
Talking about India, the Japanese president is there, right?
He's just left. He's now at the United Nations, so he's nearer to you, Mr. Abe. He's actually just a few meters away from you. But yeah, he was in Ahmedabad for 2 days, yeah?
Did a prime minister and him like hold hands, walk together somewhere?
Something like that. But the most interesting part of that was that all of Ahmedabad had school children with Japanese flags. Bear in mind that none of them had heard of Japan or Japanese flags before that moment. And but they put up a fabulous show.
They just thought it was the candy. There for the candy.
Don't make fun of the Japanese flag. It was once a very imperialist nation. It can rise again. The sun rises in the east.
I am safe. I'm the guy who's safe.
Yeah. You're the guys who bullied Japan. Yeah, but what about us? We're in the middle of everything. We got North Korea on the right, for God's sake. He's not that far away. Kim Jong with the best haircut in the world. What are your views on Kim Jong?
Maybe Modi and Shinzo Abe were doing a jai viru on the friendship thing.
Oh, they get along very well. They hugged and everything. See, our fellow is known for his hugging.
Cyrus, who do you think would play Jai and who do you think would play the big brother
this
Jai?
This is a dirty, loaded question, Mr. Mahim Gautam, because you know very well that Jai dies. And if I spin one, that guy dies at the end of the show. So I'm not doing that. I will not. I will put one of them as Thakur. The one who's doing less work because you don't need your arms.
You still have to live there, right?
Hey, you're telling me.
I'm in the country.
I'm 10 minutes away from the real Mahim. That's where the trouble starts. Be careful. All right, brother, sorry. So, favorite episode was?
I think Suresh and
Jose.
Suresh and Jose, and also Karl Katgara.
Karl!
Because then he revealed all, most of his secrets got revealed in Karl Katgara.
Because we go back a long way, MTV days and all that. Lovely guy, half Parsi also, you know, genetics all over the place. Lovely man. And of course.
You always favor your people.
Well, everybody favors their people.
You should, right?
Yeah, but we have to because our people are like nine. We're like a rock band now. We're not even like a tribe. We're just a few people scattered here and there. All right, bro.
Right.
Any feedback you want to give us? Because you're rated as our top three fans in terms of what
you guys are doing. Awesome.
Superb. Thanks so much. Can you see that five more times so we can act like it's reverb and all that? That we don't have to use the technology.
Yeah. Sure. I can like record it and send it. You can pay in starting of the show.
Since it's 1:30 in the morning or whatever there while we record this, what are you doing right now? I mean, what were you doing? Did we wake you?
I was kind of like planning to get up before the call, but the call woke me up. So
I'm so sorry. Bro, I'm also watching. Of course, people can't see this, but I don't know. Naveen, you can take a picture. You're sitting on a chair which looks either like a barber's shop ka chair or a car chair. Are you in a car?
Yeah, I'm in my car right now.
Are you kidding me? Can you blow the horn? Can you blow the horn?
I would wake up the people. So
blow one horn. One horn, bro.
I can make fake sounds. Like,
That doesn't prove anything. I need to see something more. Can I see the window? Can you show me the window?
Sure, yeah.
Oh my God, okay. Brother, you're in the car. You're really Indian. He's such a cheapo. He's to save rent money. The brother lives in his car. I love you. You're the typical Indian story, mate. He's going to be a multi-millionaire, a software king, but he'll live inside his Mazda.
Hey, I'm not the software king. I'm the guy who like does the mechanic thing in here.
1 minute. Then you should be below the car if you're the mechanic. You're in the wrong place. Yeah, cheers, Mimes.
I should be. Yeah.
Listen, thank you for being a sport. I'm sorry to keep you up and pull your leg and all that, but you've been a wonderful support to us. In terms of bras, you're the best that we have. You've really supported us from the beginning. And let's hope to get more feedback from you. And as the show grows one way or the other, we hope to have you along on the ride.
Sure, you guys are doing good. I enjoy the show.
Cheers, mate. All right, have a good one. I know it's late for you. Thanks so much. Really, thanks. Appreciate this really a lot. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
All right, next up here on Cyrus Says, special 200 edition, for which I am wearing an outfit designed by Tarun Thailiani's watchman, Ramprasad. He left after giving me this outfit because he had nothing to wear himself. We have somewhere in Chennai another gentleman who's been quite, shall we say, supportive. He's been there for us from the beginning. Rohit Rai, how are you doing?
Amazing, Cyrus. How are you?
Man, I must say, you're looking damn good. Huh? This modern technology, he's lit up better than our studio when we shoot. And all he's got is put the light on. You just put the light on in the...
Thanks to my office.
Oh, you're in the office. No wonder. It's
very... Shh.
Okay, where do you work?
Should I say that?
Yeah, it's okay. We'll find out. They can Google you, Rohit Rai Chennai. In 2 seconds, everyone know where you work.
So I work for Shell in Bangalore.
Oh, you work for Shell. Oh, okay. Let's just say it's lunch break, huh? Lunch break. So you're not breaking any rules.
It is legit lunch. It's 12, yeah. Close to 12.
What we call in Mumbai, the running lunch, where you know you just go to have lunch anytime and then come back. Yeah. Okay, Rohit, I won't waste your time. Let's get right to it. So we are trying to celebrate our glory. And after years of searching, we found 3 or 4 people who actually, you know, more than once have sent us an email. Your name cropped up. Sorry. So we are after you after that. Just a couple of things. Tell us what you like about our show, if you can just in short and sweet.
Go for it.
No, in case there's nothing you like about the show, that's good too. Huh? Yeah.
No. So I think I listen to it mainly because of your wit. I think it's all about you rather than the guest. I don't be surprised. You know that, Cyrus.
I listen to it for the guest.
So self-appreciation is not counted, is it?
No, because we have a department that searches for these guests and you just rubbish them and throw them out. And we have to pay money to those guys.
I've actually sent out names of people who can invite, but
really?
They don't listen to me.
Hang in there. Wait. Let me talk to my... this is all live, bro. One sec. Naveen, you heard him. It's a criticism. He's been sending... And since he follows the show, he knows what kind of profile works. And you have disregarded him. I screamed at Naveen.
Yes, blame everybody, Cyrus.
I screamed at him. By the way, can you give us a couple of those guests that you suggested? Who were they? And please don't tell me Rajnikanth and Kamal Haasan, because it'll be a little difficult to arrange with all the influence that we have.
So I've been born and raised in Chennai, but I'm all my life. I am from Lucknow, so I'm a North Indian.
Oh my God! Oh my God! You're from Lucknow. What? You must have no friends in Chennai. What are you doing?
No. I have all my friends in Chennai, but I'm in Bangalore now. So.
What? This is the Indian story. Yeah. But one of our guys beat you to it. Yeah. They're from Detroit. And actually now in Pune, but actually not even from Pune. So it's all over the place. Sorry, so coming back, who do you suggest could come on the show?
Oh, I think there's an indie music singer called Malvika Manoj. Goes by the name Mally. So I think you can call her. I think she's amazing.
Mally can be quite pally. Hang in there. Take down her name.
You worked with her, Cyrus.
I've worked with Malvika. We know her very well.
Yeah.
So I've been told.
Is it?
Yes.
Oh, she's... No, she's damn good.
You can see how sincere I am when it comes to podcasts. Oh, I know everyone.
You have no clue, Cyrus. I know that.
No clue. Thank God I'm not a doctor. Imagine you, the same woman comes to deliver children every year and you have no idea. Yeah, but not that Malvika is delivering. Not like that at all. Anybody else?
So I've been asking to have a cricket show because I send you many cricket questions.
Right.
I follow cricket very passionately.
Right.
But so not a quintessential cricket follower, but not like you either.
Cricket Info. Why don't you come onto that one? You can actually participate.
I've seen many of your shows. I mean, it goes by
run order. Run order.
Yes, I've seen many of them. I think you crack dirty jokes in that.
Yeah, it's too short. That's the problem. It's just 2-3 minute vignettes. So cricket. Who else?
But there are so many legends there, starting with Akash Chopra. So.
He's pretty good, yeah. Come on. And listen, Akash Chopra gave us a really good start in a couple of seasons, especially in the series against Australia. You know, people forget that he was a decent opening batsman, no doubt, now that you brought it up.
Oh, he went to Australian tour and he did quite well. So I remember, yeah. He's good, of course.
And then after that, you had Dravid and company hammering the Australian bowlers. So you needed that opening partnership with Viru Sehwag. But let's move on from there, otherwise I'll get fired.
Totally. I mean, who are we to talk about?
Yeah, exactly. Who the hell are we, really? So who else? Who else can we feature?
So after listening to Ayaz Maimon's show, I've been asking you guys to please bring in some expert to talk about cricket because I love that show. That was amazing. So yeah. I mean, he spoke about so many histories and all those intricate details about cricket. That was very good. They brought in a few cricket journalists. I mean, all that is all right, but I think someone with that stature is very good for the show. I mean, I love that show. I've been asking to bring someone.
You know what you're talking about is more like the after dinner cricket speakers. I've also been telling these guys to get those kind of guys because they're telling you anecdotes and stories which are more human and fun.
Exactly.
And not just about, you know, ball beating the bat. So So I think you're spot on. You know, the sledging and the fight in the dressing room and this and that. And who was the first lady he mated with, you know. These are the things that come out, you know.
So you managed to crack a dirty joke with Ayaz Maimon as well. I mean, he rubbed you off, so.
Ayaz and I go back a long way. When I was a swimmer, under 14 swimming thing, he was a young journalist, he used to cover swimming. So he remembers me from then. So imagine he's seen me in a Speedo costume. So between my wife Aisha and Ayaz, they have seen everything. I got to tell you, honestly. Maybe Ayaz has seen more, to be frank. And that's upset him and affected him, and hence he's doing a podcast now to get over it. Okay, I interrupt you. Yeah. Tell us about yourself, Rohit Rai, except that you're from Lucknow and now in Chennai. We don't know much about you. What do you do? You're in Shell.
I'm from Lucknow, born raised in Chennai, in Bangalore. So you won't believe I started at 10 a.m. this morning. My home is 4 kilometers out and it took 2 hours to reach. And you guys talk about Mumbai? Come on.
No. I've suffered Bangalore. I've done shows there.
Bangalore is horrible.
In that, I think Whitefield, is it? One terrible mall had come up and oh my God, we took 45 minutes to go 1 kilometer. So I can know exactly what you're saying. And that airport, by the way, they keep moving it. They move it beyond Mysore. Now it's going towards Kerala. That airport is nowhere in Karnataka. It's nowhere next to Karnataka.
Oh, it's 60 kilometers out of the city. I mean, come on.
I'm told Dr. Vijay Mallya has taken the airport with him. So you can't find either. That's the latest report. Yeah.
Maybe.
What's happening? Rohit, what's happening to our country? Bangalore was the city of India. When I was a young man in the 90s, we all loved Bangalore because it was orderly, it was friendly, it was warm, the bars were open.
The bars were open,
10 o'clock, you know, shut down. Yeah, it was green, cosmopolitan.
Foam. You remember the foam story?
Yes, I remember the foam. And not to mention what kind of going on happened to journalists and this and that. So, I mean, there's no end to it. At the moment, I'm very disappointed, frankly speaking, in our top 5 cities. So let's get back to the show and tell us what you'd like to see on the show different. You've talked about cricket show. Is there any way we can improve the quality of the show? I mean, every way we'll improve it, but if you could name a few.
All right, so I think you bring in a lot of comedians because I don't.
That's Naveen, the podcaster, producer, who's a comedian, actual stand-up comedian. And he tries to help his friends and family. I don't know, there's some deal going on there. I hate comedians. Yeah. I can't stand them. I only want women NGO workers who are very sensitive and compassionate.
Women.
NGO workers who are incidentally women and who will feel bad for me and give up the NGO and take me up instead. My whole thing is different. But Naveen is the comedy lover. Go on. Good point. Too many comedians. Yeah, next.
Too many comedians. And you won't believe that. So last year when I was listening to your shows, whenever there was a woman on your show, I went on Facebook and tried to search and like her. And that was creepy of me, but now it's all set. It's good. I think I started...
If you know it's creepy, why would you do it, man?
There's too much time on the traffic.
I realized it later.
Oh God, that's hilarious. What do you think? Oh, I heard you on the show. Love you. Hey, did you get any feedback? Did you get any, Rohit, did you get any feedback from any girl or any of the girls on the show?
No one replies, dude.
Bro, now you know my world. Welcome. Welcome to my world. He knows everything now.
But he is a handsome guy.
And that's why we have comedians on the show, because they will reply. See, that's the difference.
They will reply. Yeah.
Okay,
why not someone like Johnny Lever?
Oh, I've actually worked in a film with Johnny Lever. It's fantastic. I don't mind, but who'll get him? Who'll reach him?
You don't have to pay him.
No, you won't have to pay him. He's a lovely guy. If you can get him, he'll come here. He knows we have no money. Don't worry. And it'll be a different experience. I have no problem. It would be great. Let me talk to him.
Yeah.
Naveen, Johnny Lever. See if we can do it.
Johnny Lever.
Yeah. This generation doesn't know Johnny Lever, mate. That's you and me. This guy behind me, Naveen, he likes all these young comedians with their silly jokes that they've stolen from the internet. And he does a geography only from Bandra to Bhandup. If you're beyond or in front of that, he doesn't let you come on. It's all kinds of issues.
I'm from Bandra, by the way.
Why did I bring up Bandup? I apologize. I'm so sorry. Rohit, we're having an internal show while you're there in Bangalore via Chennai. Acha, so the question I want to ask you is, which is your favorite episode? By the way, that was the actual question of the whole introduction that we were leading to.
So I've told you about IL Women. Apart from that, I think Neha Dhopia, she was hilarious.
Yeah.
Did you
go on Facebook and try and friend her immediately?
Come on, Cyrus.
but that would be fair, because she's like a known star, so that would be fair. How sad?
Oh, she's good. She's so Gul Panag, one of the other actor.
Now you sound creepy. From Ayaz, you've gone straight to the women who are in Bollywood.
You won't believe. So you put out Pepon is coming on your show, and I was very eager to listen to that pod, and he was a letdown. I don't know
really?
Why.
The singer? I thought he was great.
They must have cut
it very badly then. I blame them.
No.
He was very open. He sang. Yeah. He was fun. Okay, but they're good to know.
He was not fun. Okay. But anyways, I mean, he's amazing.
You're the listener, man. You're right. If you didn't like it, you didn't like it. There's nothing we can do. Let me just talk to my producer again, live on camera. What the hell's wrong with you, man? You didn't like Pepon. Cool. Okay.
But you're right. Maybe the editing was not good. Blame the producer.
No, honestly, he just appeared to be very nice and laid back and down to earth. But obviously, if that didn't come across, then well, that's the way it is. Can't deny.
Mr. Khatri was very good.
The comedian.
You
abuse all the comedians. Now you said good things about Khatri, and now that looks terrible. So we can get Khatri back. We'll get him back, but not as a comedian. We'll tell him to come back as a singer.
Yeah.
So we can get the preponderance.
Singer or a businessman.
Huh. Then who else? Any like ordinary guys that you remember who were not famous?
I think the Hiranandani lady, if I remember.
So you know the surname, but can't remember the first name. Yes, very good. Fair enough. Yeah.
You,
she was quite entertaining. Did you find her interesting as in funny?
She was. I mean, when I was the creepy myself, I was trying to find funny. But anyways, yeah, she was good.
Did you Facebook her?
No. Yes.
Excellent. She'll never come back on our show again, bro. Okay. Thanks a lot for being on the show.
I tried to find May, but because I find her voice very lovely, but I don't.
You couldn't get May on Facebook?
No.
What are you saying?
I think she's very private.
No, she's over friendly.
Yeah.
She hugs all the time.
It's May.
I've been telling her not to.
I've heard that, yes.
Yeah, look for May Mariam Thomas.
May Mariam Thomas is a full name, in case you want to do that again. I think May alone is not working.
She'll give you a virtual hug.
You'll get a virtual hug, and she's one of those human beings who's always got love in her heart. And no drugs, as far as I know.
I can hear that on the pod, yeah.
So try that again. Yeah. Anyway, Rohit, I think we've come to the end of the circle of life. Cheers, mate, as we say in Australia. Thank you for being on the show, and hope to hear from you. Well, every episode, as usual.
Honestly, Cyrus, I wait for your podcast. I think it's a very good, pod you're doing. I mean, keep it doing.
Hi, I'm Amit Verma, the host of the weekly podcast, The Seen and the Unseen. In my show, I examine the seen effects and the unintended consequences of public policy and private action. I show how policies meant to help the poor often end up hurting the poor. I've done episodes so far on demonetization, GST, surgical strikes, immigration and MRP. And I will continue my forensic assault on the truth in the weeks to come.
Catch the show every Monday on the IVM podcast app or any other podcasting app that you prefer. Or visit sceneunseen.in for all the latest updates.
Here on Cyrus Says 200 episode, very excited. We have a new guest. Abhishek has joined us, but at the same time, we've also got me.
Yeah, I know.
Who's popped in for some reason. Can I use the word popped in?
Yes,
not
you can.
Popped out.
Ew. But oops. I came all the way from Andheri for this, you know that. Right?
I came all the way from Malwa Hill, which used to be the end of Mumbai in 1962. By the way, Abhishek, let me tell you, young man, yeah. Are you from Mumbai?
He's just called you a young man. No. I'm warning you. Be warned. Young man, you've been already patronized from the start.
Dude, yeah. I'm young, dude.
Young man. or to give you a full name, Young Man's Christian Association, where you stay. No. So just very quickly, the last tiger was sighted in Malabar Hill in 1962. Like a real tiger. Feline.
Where's
animal.
Malabar Hill now?
Okay, so it's somewhere where the poor
is
people live.
Is that what live. They used to call you in Malabar Hill?
Garibo ka buildings hai wahan pe, where the poor live. And so I still stay with my parents. That's a sign. As my brother-in-law, he thinks I'm a failure. He's like, you're in your 40s and you stay with your parents. Obviously, I am. In America, if you stay with the parents, and either the parents are really sick at that point or you're a failure. So he's just very clear about it. Because at 18, they move out. It's a different world, man, America. Look at Donald Trump. Had his own building at 18. Me, nothing. Abhishek, introduce yourself. You're one of our so-called... Is fan the right word? Very bad
fan.
Word.
Fan, yeah.
Fan. Abhishek Menon, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, God, you're both Malus.
Oh, God, you're Malali.
What is saying?
Sir.
That's it. I'm done with the show. I won't speak again. I've got two Malayalis in the same room. I'm finished.
Can I tell you, Cyrus has this really great affinity for Malus. He loves them. I think he's really drawn to them all the time.
I have worked per square inch. It must be the... After Kerala and after Dubai, it must be the most Malayali
The Malus are everywhere. Infested, like, every other...
No, we used to call MTV Malayali TV.
Oh.
Because
it is true.
Our boss was Malayali. Our head of production was Malayali. Bakra guy Vasant was Malayali. Malaika is basically Malayali because the father left, so she's brought up by her mom. So everybody, you know, was that rude? I'm sorry, Malaika. I didn't mean it that way. What I mean is, you know,
we're going to get her on next week, right?
Yeah. So MTV was Malayalam television, as far as we were considered.
This is when you're
it's a good affinity. It's a good
you're
affinity.
You're meant to be spooned on either side by Malayalis.
By the way, I know a lot of Galis in Malayalam thanks to all these guys in my life in the
90s. I'm so scared what's going to happen right now. My mother's not going to listen to this episode clearly.
I'm sure she knows the Galis.
My mom's going to listen to this episode.
Yeah, what do you say? How can you not know the Galis if that's your mother tongue?
She does know.
Or your mother's tongue in this case.
Ew!
Well, what? We just brought it up. Abhishek, welcome to the show, by the way.
Thanks, man.
What the hell have you written on your t-shirt? Is I Tatti Tere Naam Kya Hai?
Tere Naam Kya Hai?
Is Biswa.
Biswa the comedian.
Yeah.
He's like Shakespeare now. Wear t-shirts with Biswa. Biswa from Hamlet. Biswa from Macbeth.
I haven't even written his name, you know, that is from him.
Yeah. No, you know it's from him in the word. When it starts with I-Tatti, it's either him or me.
Yeah,
what are the options? It's not really Hamlet. Okay, bro, let's talk about the show. By the way, this is about praising our show.
Is it?
200 webisode. Podcast episode.
I cannot believe it's been 200 episodes.
200. In fact, I've just done some research and most Indian podcasts started by Indians end between the 50th and 75th. Nobody goes to 200. We are amongst the...
You must be so proud. You should do something like...
There's only 1% above us.
Yeah.
KRK.
Like, pee off the top of the building. Do something like really big to like market.
She doesn't react to KRK. But educated
person
like you.
Do you want to
bring
him on the show?
I've heard of KRK. I don't know.
He is arguably the greatest Indian the world has ever seen. Since Aryabhatta and maybe Tulsidas and, you know... I don't know if you've read Ramacharitmanas, one of the great books written by one of our greats, but he's arguably above all that.
KRK.
Look at Abhishek's reaction when you say his name. I'll give you three Indians who are famous in contemporary times, okay? And you see Abhishek's reaction. Sachin Tendulkar, not much. No. Shah Rukh Khan, not much. KRK.
Oh.
His hair.
Oh my God.
His hair has shifted. And he's got hair which can kind of cover the whole of Bangladesh. Yeah. So much.
All right. Hey, but all Malayalis have hair like that. They basically just move independently of whether the wind blows or
is that so?
Yeah. So all wind blows right.
I watched I.M. Vijayan play a football match in Cooperage once and his hair was nothing like this.
Really?
No, all Malayalis, I don't think they have long hair.
Are you going to have an inter-Malayali conversation about genetics
Malu
now?
Malu hair moves. Like my hair like lands up somewhere else.
Is that the is that the quality of this great show?
Yeah.
We discussed Aryabhatta a few minutes back and now we're down to
and
Aryabhatta.
Malu hair.
What the hell?
So
coming back to Malu hair, you tell us about it. How has your experience been with this hair? Does it help you when you run? Arguably very good genetics for running. I mean, you've got so many middle distance runners that have come out of God's own country. So maybe the hair helps.
I don't think so, like, because I'm just zoned out. Yeah.
You're zoned out. You don't want to answer the question.
I think he's really excited to see your
face. Yeah, actually.
I think he wants to meet Biswa. He's really disappointed.
He thought it was Biswa. Like, you know, and you, he's like, oh, this guy's
you go to the zoo and you want to see the polar bear and then there's just one of those, you know, those small monkeys. You're like, oh, okay, chalo, theek hai. Monkey ko dekhna padega. Where is the polar bear? That's what he's going to.
Yeah. I thought they were just going to paint the brown one white.
How could you be racist in bears and monkeys? Or animals in general? What kind of person are you?
I'm Malayali. We're quite.
You are very prejudiced people. Very terrible.
You have, for hanging out with Mallu so much, you have the worst Mallu accent.
Really?
I don't know how you do this.
It's not terrible.
Terrible?
Then what is it?
You sound like
Mr.
a Punjabi.
Mr. Menon, what is it?
Like,
true, I'm just
to...
like so like freaked out.
Punjabi is terrible. It's different. Huh? See, Punjabis are very lazy. They don't want to say
you
the first.
You sound like a Malayali trying to.
The first, in Punjabi, the first word is wasted. That's why when they say the bad word, you don't hear the pain. You think they're sneezing? It's a different culture altogether. We want to talk about the show. 200 episode, the glorious uncertainties of the game. What we've been through, young.
I knew it would last so long, you know, because like
you didn't think it would. Are you?
I did.
You sound like my wife.
go on. Because like this, this what Cyrus says, right? When I like, I have to commute like 25 kilometers to college, and like
why
this
is,
25 kilometers to college?
Are you a cyclist? Do you deliver
college?
Supplies?
It's where college.
So are you doing college in Bombay and living in Pune or something?
Let me do the jokes. Let me do the jokes.
Sorry.
And the geography.
I can't believe it's so far.
Where is college?
It's around like 25 kilometers from my place. And then
where?
It's
Man,
in Katraj. Pune.
We know that, of course we know. On the map, show us where it is. Exactly.
Near Katraj.
I know Karadi. That's
no
a
Cambridge,
cool place.
No
in
Cambridge.
Pune.
Yeah, this is next story.
Next stop. But 25 km, that's a longish ride.
Where do
yeah.
you live?
I live.
What
do
you want to live with him?
Yeah.
Why are you asking all these questions?
No, I might want to go to his house when I go to Pune next.
But you just told me that Malayalis aren't welcome at Malayali houses.
Yeah,
you explained that. That's law number one.
I did not say that.
Mr. Menon is not interested in having you over.
By the way, talking about Malayali, happy Onam, man.
Yeah, happy Onam.
He's not so excited, man.
My mom told me in the morning it's Onam, you know, the same day.
It was Onam. It's not Onam now. Even I know that.
Did you go for Sadhya?
No, but I did wish people.
That's quite sweet.
Yeah.
You on your
I'm very secular. I'm even while Ram Rahim was being dragged to court, I was wishing people for some other festival in China. So I got to tell you, I'm very secular. And on the day of Onam, of course, we had our own tragedies, but I went for it. I went for it immediately.
That's quite sweet.
But like, can we talk about him? Because it's his
yeah,
show,
I'm so
and
sorry.
If you don't mind. Yeah. 200 episodes. So you said you didn't expect us to last more than 10, and then.
Yeah. And then you did.
That's it.
That's
why
really
bother coming from Pune? You've given us absolutely nothing. You're amongst the worst guests we've ever had.
That's the support that
no,
we that
travels,
be like.
You know why travels?
Disbelief.
You know why travels?
Then, wow.
Why, 25 kilometers makes sense now. The college authorities want him to go as far as possible. His contribution to the college is zero. Yeah. So best shows or anything that you remember? Is anything in your head from the shows that you listen to?
Every cock and bull is the best. And
oh,
then
that's you.
Hey, that's us.
That's all about you.
Not in your episode. In one which Kunal and
Wait, hold. We've got to put the relevant laugh track here. My God. Are you guys always so mean to me?
No, you know, because you're shit.
This is typical Indians, huh? When we are of the same culture, we even worse to each other. That's true.
It makes sense. As Malayalis, Malus are the Malus, of course.
Sad. Me, I must say, I really enjoy you on Cock and Bull for whatever reason.
I know. I'm glad someone does.
Yeah. Then?
And then there's Kunal Kamras. That
Kunal
is the best.
Kamra, yeah. Now that's a comedian I admire.
Yeah.
And he used to work with us at MTV. Awesome. Anyone who worked with us at MTV does well.
Yeah?
Yeah. Because we free them, no? From the pain. They change immediately.
And which was that comedian in which
yeah, go on.
He bowled Rohan Uthappa out.
He bowled to Robin Uthappa.
Robin Uthappa,
Rohan
yeah.
Uthappa must be his brother. Robin Uthappa is the cricketer.
Robin Uthappa, yeah.
He's half Malayali, by the way, at least for some. That should count. Robin Uthappa is half Kurgi, half Malayali.
Yeah,
let's
yeah.
not get into cricket detailing, because then I'm alone like a loser here talking to myself. Huh?
That is true.
Yeah. I might as well, you know, just do Carnatic vocals with you after that. So who's this guy who bowled to Robin Uthappa?
I was trying to figure it out.
And he was a comedian.
Yeah, was it?
Why don't we pay attention to our own shows? The engineers don't know, the producer doesn't know, the co-anchor doesn't know.
I actually don't think Naveen was.
And the so-called fan vaguely knows. This show sucks. That's very clear. This show sucks.
Wait a minute.
We don't know. He doesn't know either. He gives you half details.
Baba, I've been on the most cock and boom episodes, and I'm the one thing he doesn't like.
I know. Shah Rukh Khan fans, when they come and meet him, they tell him everything from his father downwards. They know every detail. His income tax statements, they know. This guy, who's supposed to be our biggest fan, with due respect, struggled to come up with the wrong. wrong cricketer's name. He married him off to some other guy, put it together, and then he called a comedian who probably didn't appear on our show and said he bowled to him. And none of us have a memory of this incident. This is the
proof. None of us.
What kind of show is this? I'm just so depressed.
Rohan Joshi. I think it was Rohan Joshi, yeah.
But why would Rohan Joshi be bowling to Robin Uthappa?
He played cricket for a while, that's why.
Yeah, right.
You're right. See, he's right. You're right.
I'm right. And it was not even when I was here.
Yeah, he played cricket for a while. And he lived in Chennai and then Bangalore.
And then he met him later. And then he's like,
correct. You're right. Now it's coming back to me. Not bad. For a fan, you have a vague idea of what happens.
Yeah.
And for an anchor, I also have a vague idea. I mean, we're real professionals. Crack professionals, two of us. Are you impressed? Do you know who Robin Uthappa is? Have you seen the Batman franchise? Because he's not in it.
Can I tell you, Robin Uthappa sounds
if
like
Batman
a
was
guy.
A Kurgi, then maybe. Robin! With gun in hand. And not such tight vests. Okay, sir, anything else? One last question. No, but before one last question, anything else?
I don't know, like, who says the question that has been asked to you? Because I sent like around 6-7 questions and just one has been asked.
I'll tell you. Yeah. Because I can see the angst. You're like Amitabh Bachchan, but in this century.
Yeah, every...
No, I'll tell you. I'll tell you because I know exactly what you're trying to say. Your anger is that you send... You're very enthusiastic. You send a lot of information.
Yeah.
And
stupid
it's disregarded.
Okay? Yeah.
Now, there's only one person who can do that. The producer.
No,
she's a soft target, a lovely girl. She'll never do anything.
Thank you. I've really been
engineer is not his job. Engineers, their job is only the technical part of it.
Anyone you have to jack, that guy with the...
Me, so I have the attention span of a pigeon. So it can't be me. So who is it? Now look at that gentleman.
Is it Noven?
Yeah.
Noven, no.
It is
Naveen.
All Naveen.
But you call him Noven. After you call Robin Uthappa Rohit, so it doesn't matter. And Rohan Joshi something else. So you call anybody anything you want. And your philosopher Biswa will guide you. He's the Aristotle of today. You don't worry. Oh, man. So Baba, why don't you pay attention?
I did.
Can you come on the mic and answer? Yeah. This is Naveen's reply.
I did feature a lot of questions, but most of just Abhishek's one. Questions are like, you know, when will you get this one on the show? That question.
No. I asked like, should marijuana be legalized?
Marijuana legalized.
The
episode is not out yet, Abhishek. Stop judging me before you even.
Dude, I feel so bad, though. Like, when the episode releases, I skip to the AMAs and then, like, my question is asked.
You skipped to the AMAs?
So it's all about you. You selfish bastard. You don't care about us and our show. You want to hear your name. In which case, we'll just say your name throughout the show. Mention Abhishek's name 5 times in the 1 hour show, please. Whatever happens. It'll be done, sir. Don't worry. To please you. After all,
first is the AMAs and then I start the episode, you know, because, like...
That's we should okay. just do the AMAs in the beginning.
Yeah. And just for the record, in Kerala, you eat dessert first. So it all makes sense. It all makes sense.
Oh, yeah.
You can switch everything.
Like palharams and all that.
See how fast my mind is. And this is the curse I've had since childhood. My mind was fast. Now my body is also fast. So no girl stays.
Your body is now caught up with your mind?
It's all gone too fast. I have an orgasm. I have an orgasm before I have an erection. It's the only person in the world who's been... I don't know. Maybe Biswa the philosopher can throw some in his eye tatty overview of the world. Explain it.
I have no words for you.
I don't know why these things happen. But Abhishek, thank you so much. Abhishek Menon, for being on our show. And more importantly, for being a supporter.
Yeah.
In your own way. And I'm so sorry that you've been disrespected. I will make sure that your questions are regarding.
No.
And we will at least read them out and not answer them. But we'll read them out.
Oh. Yeah.
All right, Abhishek, thanks so much for being on the show. It's our 200 special and we wanted to validate you as a person who's actually listened to maybe 3 to 4 podcasts.
No.
5?
Try, listen to everything, dude.
What are you saying, bro?
Yeah.
You're like my mother, but with more hair. All right, so we'll stop here for a second on our 200 special and go into break. I won't tell you what's coming up because I have no idea.
Shunya one. $1 billion acquisition. Another copycat startup got formed.
No, the tech world in India is surely moving double the speed of this voiceover.
Tune in to Shunya One every Tuesday to catch us talking to the smartest people we know on the IVM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcasts from.
Okay, here on our spepisode, we're talking to our leading lights, people who have been staying in touch with us. And from the beginning of the show, or rather the beginning of the birth of this show, we have with us Briefless Attorney. And for my memory, the first guy I remember as a guy who kept coming back and giving us feedback. Briefless Attorney, sir. Kaise ho, sir? Are you there?
So far, so good, Cyrus.
So far, so good. Briefless, what do we call you? Do we call you Brief, Briefless, Briefy? Is there another name under all that?
No, you just call me Briefless.
Yeah, I think
that's how I usually roam around in courts in one sense or the other.
Yeah, well, I'm not a judge, so you'll get away with that, young man. Yeah, but we're talking about our show, and we want to know from you some feedback, some things that you remember. Which is the episode that you enjoy the most? Is there one that you remember?
I think the one between you and Kunal.
Kunal Vijaykar?
Kunal Vijaykar. Yeah. Is there any other Kunal? Yes.
Well, there's Kunal Kemu, Kunal Kamra. There've been a couple.
Yeah, no. I think just Kunal Ekar is the one that I remember.
Yeah, because he's known as my. Sorry,
the Karkala story.
Yeah, that's actually a very popular story. Apparently. I've heard a bunch of people talk about that Karkala story as like the funniest thing they've heard on the show.
Is it? It must be true. But yeah, we call him my other wife. So you confuse me. Nobody calls him Kunal anymore. In fact, now my wife is called the other wife. It's that confusing. Yeah. Anyway.
Cyrus, you take my word for it. We are here in the Supreme Court fighting for your rights.
One-zero briefless. Well played. Half time, you go in, you change, you're leading one love. Gonna have to change the striker on the next lot. Yeah. All right. So, talking about the show again, is there any other guest that stands out? Any celebrity guest that you remember? We just want to look at it from a nostalgic point of view because we may close it down. We're all bored.
No, well, don't do that because I believe the first few episodes where there was a conversation between a panel of people were really the most interesting ones because there was no agenda there. Those are the ones that sort of made me catch on to the show. And,
you know, you're amazing.
I
didn't remember this till you just mentioned it, but yes, we did start with a lot of people. It was more like a poor man's Arnob. Now he's become a poor man's Arnob, and we've taken it a little further. But yeah, very interesting. Yeah, we should bring that back. Mr. Amit Doshi, who's with us here.
Yeah, you really should.
Yeah, so we should do
panel
that.
Discussions. We had 3-4 people, different opinions, and you know, going for it. Yeah, excellent.
We should do. Can I
be honest?
Please.
Can I be honest?
Please, we can always edit it.
I enjoyed that more because I feel like you guys have sold out now where you have an agenda with the guest. So you mustn't do that. You must stay true to your roots.
Okay, you upset and hurt my entire team in one single blow. No, but I get you. I think that's a very fair point. We need to mix it up a bit with the panels.
Out, I mean, like, isn't legal tender a kind of requirement prior to selling out?
I'll qualify my statement with respect. When you say with respect, you get away with everything.
Briefless, you're one of our equity holders. Your word counts for a lot. It's not a criticism. We're looking forward to engineering a few changes here and there. So this is good. We forgot. Thanks to you, we now remember the panel idea. And the whole panel idea has another energy. You're right. You're absolutely right.
Yeah, no, so, we should start doing a lot more of those, I think. I think we should do them on a fairly regular basis. At least, like, you know, like maybe... So the cock and bull was kind of an extension of that idea, right?
It is.
Like,
the cock and bull is a lot of fun. The cock and bull really is a lot of fun.
Yeah. So I think that's kind of... That was a way to kind of get that going a little bit. But
yeah, our worry is that the government may ban bull and cock soon. So we're worried about, we'll have about to change that, the name then. We'll go find something else.
Cyrus, you have a standing counsel in me in the Supreme Court and the Bombay High Court.
But do you know the rates you charge?
Anything, we go ahead and challenge it.
Mr. Attorney, do you know how much you charge? I'd rather lose the case. What are you saying?
No, I make a promise to you on record that for you, I'll charge 50% of what. The
50%?
Best part is you don't know otherwise, so I can get away with anything.
Can we haggle? All right, Briefless, this has been a great pleasure talking to you, and I hope you listen to the rest of our podcast. And yeah, we're going to take what you said seriously. It's a very good point, and I think you're spot on. We will get the panelists back. Briefless Attorney on our special spebisode. Okay, we're now on this episode. We got a guy in Bangalore who's waiting to talk to us. His name is Shreyas. Apparently, he's one of our fans. Let's talk to him right now. Shreyas, can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you.
How are you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm not good. My hernia problem has started, and I've also got a serious case of piles, but it's internal, so the blood is not coming out onto the underwear. Other than that, I'm okay. Amit, how are you doing?
I don't suffer from the same issues as you do.
What about your hair? Everybody's got something.
I got different issues.
And Naveen, so you don't want to ask. Naveen's got every disease in the book. What are you doing, Naveen? Behave yourself. Shreyas, tell us, you've been listening to our podcast? Obviously.
Yeah, from the day one, yeah.
Day one.
I'm a great fan of yours. Means like from the week that wasn't, I'm watching all the shows.
Wow. Now I'm getting a little embarrassed.
That's because a lot of shows.
We did a market research and we have not one person who's watched our show. So, I mean, I'm going to call up that Mark guy and I'm going to fire him. There's somebody in Bangalore who, instead of watching internet porn like everybody else, is watching our show for some reason.
I used to watch one also.
Yeah, I don't think
how
they're
sweet.
Exclusive.
He's pointed out. Yeah, they are. Sometimes they merge. Okay, bro, listen, let's talk about our show, Cyrus says. So, anything that you remember, what are the highlights, shows that you like, people you liked, anything that you remember?
I like all the shows, like The Talk with Abish and Roy.
Roy is Altman. Yes, yes, of course.
Roy is Altman. Oh, yeah, Mentalist.
The Mentalist.
Mentalist, yeah.
Yeah, that was too. I like that show very much.
See, that's interesting, because Shreyas, that you mentioned that, because I feel happy that we've got different people onto
the
show.
We do, because I actually got some negative feedback for the Roy Saltzman episode.
Really?
Yeah, why are you doing something like this?
But why? Why would there be negative feedback?
It just was like, you know, that's not... people get bent out of shape about scientific, non-scientific, that kind of stuff.
Oh, as in, are they frauds?
Yeah.
Well, if they're frauds or not, it's an art form of sorts.
It's an entertainment thing.
He scared the hell out of me. Yeah. I mean, he proved a few things. And you know, when they do these tricks in front of you, I'm also quite cynical. And when they do them in front of you, you then get a little worried. You know, because honestly, you can't explain. When you can't explain, you start getting worried. It's why we have riots in India. You can't explain something, people get angry.
Yeah, angry. And you beat it up.
Wait, what else? What else? Yes, you do the talking. What else?
I don't know what to say right now.
God, you sound like my first girlfriend, but you look much better. She had a vicious beard, that chick. Yeah.
But you've been listening from the beginning, right? So, I mean, like, can you think of some of the earlier episodes? What were your thoughts around some of those?
Like the show with Neha, Dukia, and I'm not getting the name. I've watched all the shows.
Literally. Okay. All right.
Neha Dupia. So he likes the Bollywood. He's one of those nice guys who seems to like everything.
Yeah, he does.
Briefless, of course, pointed us in a certain direction. Shreyas is being very nice and very open with his affection.
Which is good. We like nice.
Shreyas,
like
we will pay you for this, huh? So even if you if you're sincere or insincere, we will pay you for all the praise. What we call tarif in Hindi. Just carry on with it, and there will be money. Money will exchange hands because we are shameless in our business. We're absolutely shameless. In any case, it's all about sponsors and things like that. Money does change hand. Shreyas, what else would you like us to do? Is there anything on our show going forward that you perhaps can suggest?
No, keep going with this, the same flow. It's going good.
You know,
I love all your shows.
I said first, you remind me of my girlfriend. You actually remind me of my mother. And I'll tell you why. She's very supportive no matter what I do. If I show her a painting I've done, which is really abysmally ugly, she'll be like, damn good. You'll be the next Hussein. So, you know, in many ways, he's more like my mother than my girlfriend. So thank you, Shreyas. That's a high honor. High honor.
It's my dream to meet you. I never got an opportunity, so whenever you're in Bangalore, so
it's a bit creepy, but yes, we'll organize it.
No, when you're in Bombay, please come.
You're welcome to our studio anytime.
Come and check out.
If I get a chance, I'll come.
Please come.
Let us know, and we'll get you.
Give us advance notice. We'll organize a hotel room, girls, massage. You like Thai massage or Malaysian? Whatever you want.
No, not interested.
What? You heard, huh? You heard it's all male. You're right. Listen, Shreyas, thank you so much for being with us here on our special spebisode where we pat ourselves on our back. And you've been a very, very loyal fan, and we thank you a lot for that. Thank you.
Cheers. You're welcome. And also, you have been very nice that you just called me up through Skype and all. That's something great.
Well, the internet allows us a few free options. That's why, I think. Nothing else.
Oh, shit. That was free. That's why.
Yeah. It was either Skype or a phone call and have to pay STD rates.
Correct.
Yeah. Oh. Okay.
Yeah. All right. Cheers. Thank you so much. Bye, Shreyas.
Yeah. Thank you.
All right. On this episode, we've now got a caller from, well, we hope he's a fan, from Pakistan, from Karachi, I think.
Yeah.
Let's go straight to him. Mr. Shazman Peter, are you there? Can we hear you?
Yes, sir. Yes, I'm here. I can hear you.
My God, you sound really sad.
Yeah, you can call me Pete.
Pete?
Yeah.
Okay. Pete is easier. Pete.
Yeah, you can call me just Pete.
You know, I've got two Pete, left and right. Sorry, Pete. Sorry. Listen, just quickly, it's about time of recording. It's about 12:30 in the afternoon, post noon in Pakistan and one in India. What do you do? Why are you sleepy?
I'm a content writer. I work in the night mostly, so I just woke up.
Oh. Well, Amit, working at night, calling yourself a content writer, there's lots to investigate about this matter with young Pete. Okay, Pete, listen, we've got a lot of feedback from you over the last year or so, and actually the full 2 years that you've been on.
You've been around, and
thank you for your support. But can you tell us anything that you remember that you really enjoyed about our show, any standout episode or moments?
Well, it's been good since I've been listening to the podcast since it started, so... You can see I've listened to each episode multiple times so far. I like your banter. I like how you don't let anyone else talk, like Arnab.
I'm letting you talk, like Arnab. This is no compliment. What the hell? You can't compare me to Arnab. Oh, Pete, you killed me. I'm dying here. Okay, go on. Sorry.
It's been fun. Actually, I'm a big podcast listener, so... it helps me, you know, stay alert when I'm working. I don't like listening to music that much, but podcasts keep me awake. So yours is one, I look forward to it. And I'm so glad you're on 2 episodes a week now.
Yeah. So what you're trying to say, let me just understand, is you prefer me to A.R. Rahman, which means this is what we should be charging.
I think so.
He puts us above the musicians.
Hey,
Pete is calling it the way it is. The man
is buy it.
He's selling it correctly. All right, Pete, any other person, or I wouldn't call them celebrities, but anybody who featured that you enjoyed the most? Do you remember? Do you have any recall? Or if it's more than one, that's fine too.
Yep, Kunal, every time he comes on, it's fun.
My God.
And I really enjoyed Rahul Bose. That was way back.
Oh, excellent.
Yeah, that was a fun show.
But Rahul Bose, Amit, yeah, he remembers the Rahul Bose episode.
That was a fun episode too. Rahul has some interesting stories, right? I mean, like, there was a whole Bengali pronunciation thing.
Yeah.
Then,
He's hilarious. Rahul Bose is really funny. And he's one of the finest mimics I know.
Yeah.
He does some great mimicry, as does Sonu Nigam. There are some guys, nobody knows the great mimics.
Yeah, I've heard that about
Shan,
him as well.
Hilarious.
Really? I've never seen that.
Shan and Sonu Nigam are like drop dead the best mimics in India. I can tell you without, they're right now, they're that good. But unfortunately, they think they're good singers, so they do the singing crap.
I guess it's all about voice control.
Pete, we haven't forgotten about you. I want to know a little bit more about the show from you. Anything you want us to do in the future, go in any direction? How about getting some talent from Pakistan?
If you can find any of that.
Right. No. Listen, I'm a big fan of the talent in Pakistan. Cricket, music, plays, writing.
Yeah.
There's lots of talent there. Okay, Pete, thank you so much for being with us, and I hope you stay with us. Are you any plans to visit India? Do you have any family here?
Not really.
What do you mean by not really?
No plans to travel in the near future, but maybe someday.
Yeah. Okay. So please come and visit us, Pete, whenever you can. I'm sure we'll be able to entertain you with Rahul Bose and Kunal Vijayakar. We'll keep them with you for 24 hours as a present. But honestly, thank you for being a great support.
Well, that's not exactly an incentive to visit.
Yeah, you can hear them on the show, man. Why would you want to come here and listen to them?
No, fair enough. Who the hell would want to spend time with Rahul and Kunal? And that too when he's come on a holiday. Right. Cheers, Pete.
Yeah.
Thank you. We'll see you. Bye-bye.
Pleasure. Okay.
Pleasure. All right, here on our episode, we've got our first lady. That sounds disgusting. We've got a lady fan or fanish or whatever, because we don't really have fans. We have people who tolerate us, so I call them fanish. And of course, that isn't a new language. She's in Melbourne, Australia, so that's like really far away. So I will speak, I know Australian, so... hello, Auntie and My King. Auntie and My King, is that you?
Hey, hi.
Okay, that's
good
it. Good day, mate. Is the extent of my Australian. Can we come back to Earth? All right. Hi, welcome. Listen, we're big fans of yours, and we just want to ask you a few questions. This is our special episode where we look at people who've been supporting us, in a sense, without money, of course. So, how are you doing, firstly?
I'm doing good.
And
sir, it's a pity you can't see me. I'm having a good headache, so I was happy.
Listen, I'm quite a creep. It's better this way. I mean,
no, I got my passport photos. I did it for my passport photos. So I'm just happy. That's why I was.
Why are you coming back to India? Let me warn you.
Yeah, I'm getting married in 2 months.
You're getting married?
Yeah.
Okay, this whole episode has gone out of the window. Now it's all about you. You're getting married and you're moving back from Australia.
No. Just getting married. The guy is in India. He's actually in Mumbai. So part of the reason why I listen to podcasts is
he's in
because
Mumbai.
I get to learn more about Mumbai.
Is it one of us?
No.
Thanks.
Not Naveen.
Thanks. not Naveen. We'll leave it at that. We won't get into that. All right. This is talking about our show, Cyrus says, since you've been listening.
Yeah.
Are there any moments that stand out that you remember that you'd like to recall?
I use your show as a reference point all the time. So from the start, like, you know, I've learned more about Mumbai. I learned about the Bori Kitchen from you guys. So I've sent my fiance on a mystery surprise date when he had no idea, just from your podcast, because I got obsessed with it.
Wow.
Nice. I bought the book, The Gujjo Guy, the American one.
Milan's book.
The guy who studied in America, Milan Vaishnav.
I bought that.
Yeah, and then came to Bihar.
That's the one.
Bihar and all that.
I bought that book. I'm reading through that right now. I have gotten booklet.
Wow.
I have last the Hot Chef thing that you had the podcast off. Oh, yeah. I ordered Aisha.
I'm getting scared. So we are like your Google. I mean, you go to Australia.
Oh, like my phone used to do in Mumbai, and you're like, and the Iranian cafes. You had a finely chopped episode, so I've written down all of them, and I even asked you questions.
Very food biased.
I don't know anything about Iranian food, so.
So it's very food biased. Are you marrying a Parsi?
No, I'm Punjabi. That should explain.
Okay, all right. Fair enough.
I'm
fair enough. We need more Punjabis in the world. You're right. Okay, listen. Auntie in making, is there any one person in particular you enjoy the most on the show? Any one guest?
No, I enjoy most of them. I don't know. I'm just trying to think which one was really hilarious.
Yeah, all right.
There was this guy who's in marketing, and he was this older guy. I can't remember his name, but he had a really nice outlook on life.
My God, you
and he was in advertising. He was in advertising from a younger age.
Saurabh Kanwar, who was in MTV.
That's the one. Yeah. Ah, so right. In advertising, a lot of famous ads.
Look, he's also Punjabi.
She's talking about Raj Kaushal.
Raj Kaushal, Mandira's husband.
Yeah.
He was, I don't know.
Mandira Bedi, the commentator, cricket expert.
I don't follow cricket either. Sorry.
What the hell? You know Raj Kaushal is, you know Mandira is.
That's actually kind of cool.
That's really cool. That's really cool, Auntie in the making. All right. So
yeah, that's one of my favorite ones. He had a really cool outlook.
Yeah, he's the one who goes on those holidays on his own and all that.
Yeah, he does the sannyasas every so often.
I think he started off as a pilot and then he just ended up in advertising.
Right.
Absolutely. Right. My God, she's damn good.
Yeah, she remembers everything.
You actually listen to a lot of our episodes. I feel like sending you money and maybe a country. You want Myanmar? They're having trouble. Listen, that's wonderful.
No, I'm happy to send you guys money. Whenever decides to start subscription, I'll be happy to sign up.
Listen, two questions. Well, keep that in mind, though. Two questions. One, when are you getting married? Exactly. And secondly...
I'm getting married...
Yeah?
In 2 months and one day, actually.
2 months and one day from the time of recording. So, somewhere in December, right?
Yeah, that sounds about right, yeah.
Not bad.
November.
Congratulations for that. And the second thing is, what would you like us to do new? Is there anything else you think you could suggest that we could do, perhaps, on the show?
Do a podcast with Amit. I know he's been interviewed in other podcasts, but I'd like...
Which Amit? Amit...
I'm in here all the time. I'm on the show like
whenever guests drop
time,
out,
yeah.
We pretend like it's a big deal.
Story.
He's very interesting. You're right. Very interesting. Because
I get bits and pieces of Shunya One. I get bits and pieces. There was that leadership podcast which I started, but I hadn't finished it because it was almost done with my drive.
Right.
But so I would like to hear more about Green and also.
Okay,
excellent. So she wants the personnel kind of story.
That's an interesting
idea. Personnel stories.
That's an interesting idea. There are a lot of interesting people who work over here. Just like the crew itself.
And in case they aren't interesting, we can lie. Because nobody really knows. So we can spin things left, right, and center.
That's the good thing.
There are things. I want to know why Amit has an American accent.
I think he
was an AD in India.
Yes,
I was.
Yes, you were.
I have an American accent because
Auntie
I was born
in the making
in
is like part of RAW or FBI. Yes,
I know
she knows everything about us. If you're cheating on your wife, any of you buggers, be very careful. She knows. Yeah.
So answer
the question.
I have an American accent because I was born in America, and it kind of just sticks. And sorry, what was the other question you asked?
No, that's good enough.
I think there was some episode where you mentioned that you were an AD back in the day.
I was. So I worked was just on a movie called Lavaris with Jackie
not
Shroff.
Not Amitabh Bachchan Lavaris. Yeah, this is the one with Akshay Khanna.
Akshay Khanna, Jackie Shroff, Manisha Koirala, and Dimple Kapadia. That so I worked on that movie as an assistant director.
And next question is, as an IBM owner, I guess that you don't have a strong drug testing policy since you've got Naveen on the show as well.
I have a zero drug testing policy. My drug testing policy is that if you have, please share.
This is India. We bend rules all the time. You're in Australia. You don't understand our culture anymore. Now when we send you a nice Punjabi, when nice Punjabi comes from there, to pata chalega. All right, listen, Auntie.
Yeah. I can't believe I'm speaking to you. I used to watch MTV Bakra and you inspired me to do pranks.
So you're another one who's younger.
That's how I got into IBM podcast. I was like, it's the Cyrus from MTV Bakra. And then I listened to you on Savin. And then, I got into IBM. And now I listen to a lot of podcasts. And every day I go for a walk and there's a new podcast on my show.
Awesome.
Yeah, listening to that.
But the sad part you've not picked up is she's much younger and she's calling herself Auntie in the Making. What does that make me?
You are grandfather in the making.
Yeah, looks like
Auntie in the Making because that's what society is. I'm currently dealing with a lot of aunties in terms of jobs and marriage. And, I've been dealing with all of this shit. I know you're going to blip that out, but
no,
the last
fine.
Few years and it gets Yeah, it gets on my nerves, and I'm like, you know what, screw it, I'll be an auntie in the making as well, and they've all got kids, and you know, they've got something coming in a few years.
Oh.
Vicious and vindictive.
Then the podcast will be the least of your problems, don't worry. Alright, listen, we're running out of time, auntie in the making, but it was a real pleasure talking to you, and you've scared the hell out of all of us, because you know more.
Why? Because I'm a keen listener.
Yeah, yeah. We didn't take this seriously, now you've given us a responsibility.
I'm going for walks to lose weight, and I'm going to start running soon as well, and it's all for the wedding, and it's really hard as a Punjabi, but that's when I listen to you guys. So, and you know, you have a really nice way of interviewing people, and I learn so much, and in 30 minutes or 1 hour, I'm learning a whole different perspective of things. So it's
all right, but when you're crossing...
Thanks so much, Amit, for organizing IBM.
No, not at all.
Be careful about crossing the road. Australians drive rashly. Okay.
No. We've got good pedestrian driving laws.
Yeah, they wait, not like us. We wait for the cow. No. They wait for the people. Yeah. All right. Thank you so much, Auntie in the Making, and all the best for your marriage as well, coming up soon.
Yeah, please invite Cyrus if it's in Bombay.
And if I come to Mumbai, which I might be.
Please come here.
Please come to the studio.
Come and meet us.
Get in touch with you guys.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, please.
All right.
Definitely. Catch you later. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye. Cheers, Mike. Cheers.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. If you have any questions, write to us online, and you can mail us as well. We will answer. We have a doctor in the house called me.
And that's what Cyrus says.
Excuse me, bhaiya. Excuse me.
Bole, madam.
Menu mein kya hai?
Menu mein Seen Unseen hai, podcast hai, on-course hai, Cyrus says hai, Made in India, Rediscovery Project, Empowering Series, Sex Wax hai, IVM Likes hai, Simplified hai, Keeping It Queer hai, Tings and Destinations hai, My Neighbor Zuckerberg hai, aur The Fan Garage hai. Aapko kya chahiye?
Ek baar repeat kar denge kya?
Repeat nahi karta hum. Aap jao ivmpodcast.com pe aur suno ye sab. Ya fir download karo unka app. Sab aapki ungliyon pe.